This tutorial is going to walk you through understanding how to use tables to format data on an existing web page. It's important to know that you should never use tables for the overall structure of the web page. Instead, for the overall structure of the web page, you should be using your div tags instead, or your div containers instead. Because there is some performance improvement when you use div. Also, your div tags are search engine friendly. Again, it's super important that you never use tables for your overall structure of your web page. So to start off exemplifying how we can create a basic table to format data, what we're gonna do is start with this basic HTML. And I'm just going to type in some information, like maybe I want to create a schedule. Okay, and so I have the information typed in so that I want to keep track of the day of the week, the time. So I have my days of weeks listed, and I'm laying out the times and looking at figuring out how I can format this. Because if I look at this HTML in a browser, it's gonna be ugly. So let's take a look and see what that looks like. So if I open this up in Chrome, you can see that the formatting that visually I had, of course, does not show up. Because the way that your web browsers work is they use HTML. Well, that's what it is a markup language. And so even though visually in my HTML, it looks like I have it formatted, of course, the browser just reads it as one big line of text. And that's why it just displays everything as a straight through line. So we need to use HTML to format this data a little bit better. The best way to do that is to go in and take a look at your HTML and identify the different places where you might want to table up the data. So if I create an overall table for this, I can see that it's going to need at the very least 4 rows and 2 columns. So let's use our HTML to create a table like that. And so you can see that I've inserted our table container there. And what I've said is I want 4 rows. So there's the first row, second row, third row, the fourth row, and within each row I've got 2 columns, and you can see there. So now I just need to go in and fill in the information from what we had before, and I'll just copy and paste to save myself some time here. Okay. And so now I have filled in our data with the markup around it to tell the browser how to display that data. Let's take a look at how it looks inside a browser. I'll use Chrome. So what you see on the screen is what we had before. And now when I refresh it after saving, now the data is nicely formatted in our tables. I purposely have a border in here so that you can see the different cells of the tables. If I want to go in now and delete the border, that's no problem. I just go in right here and take out my border equals 1 attribute. I'm going to save it and pull up my browser again, refresh, and now that border is gone. So now you have information on how to format the data using a table. Now, let's say we took out those borders, but we still want lines in between each piece of the data. It's important that you understand how to do this, because often you'll not want borders around every cell in the table, maybe just along each row. And to make that happen, you can use your rules attribute. And what that'll do, let me save real quick. What that'll do is cause a line to go in between each row. Now notice the way that I did it is I said, you know, put it along rows. That's why it has a nice little horizontal rule there between each row. And now let's say I want to put some sort of a header on this to let people know what in the world this is a schedule for. The first thing I need to consider if I'm going to put a header on this table is to figure out how many columns I have. Now we figured that out earlier when we decided we have two columns of information. So we're going to use the TH tag. And it's important to understand that you have to put that TH tag inside a row of its own. Meaning, when I have to first, of course, create my row. And now inside the row, I'm going to put information as to what sort of header I want. And by that I mean, I have to give the browser information as to how many columns that header is spanning. So we can see that we have two columns of information in this table. Therefore, when I create a header, I have to span that header two columns. And you can see I'm just going to put baseball practice schedule at the top. So I'm going to save, and then I'm going to go back to my browser and reload. And now you can see that I've got a table header there, which is centered across the top of the table. It's important to see the row spans here. That's the width of the table. So by default, that header is going to be centered in the center of the table itself. So now you have a pretty good understanding of how to use tables to format data on a web page. But again, for your overall structure of the page itself, it is important to use your div tags. Please comment or email if you have any questions.